What's going on, guys? My name is Pedrotsky, and in this video, I'm going to show you how you can change the ports that your game servers are running inside of Pterodactyl. Now, it's a pretty simple thing to do, but a lot of people seem to be a bit confused about port allocations. So I'm going to show you how you can just add whatever ports you need to whatever games you need to. So let's just start off. I'm going to use 7 Days to Die as an example. Now, as we see here, we have my server IP address followed by the port 27015. So that's the current ports that are allocated to that server instance. So I'm just going to stop that for now. And then if we click on settings, then we click on nodes, then we click on whatever node your game server is running on, and then we click on allocation. So when we click on allocation, we can see all the different ports that are available on this server. And we see here it's got 27015, 27016, etc. Now, if you just want to change to one of these ports, it's very simple. All you have to do is just go to your servers, and then I'm going to use 7 Days to Die. Then we just go over to build configuration. So build configurations, basically just all the different things, all the different options that you can do on your server when you first set it up, but this is where you can edit that. So as you see here, it says game port. So say we want to assign another port. So say we want to change this to 27017, for example. So we can just go 27017, can assign it, and then we can remove the 27015. Then we click update, and then you can see it's updated the game port to 27017. So let's say, for example, here it says, oh, let me just go into the 7 Days to Die egg. Steam CMD servers, 7 Days to Die, and now it says here 7 Days to Die requires up to 6 ports, so it's asking us to open a range of ports. Now these are the default ports, so what I'm going to do, I'm going to copy this port here, and then we're going to go back to nodes. So this is if we want to add custom ports. Then we go to allocation, and then the IP address, you can just select your current IP. And then let's say we want to open up a range of ports. So we want to open up like multiple ports here. So we just put a little dash between it and then the end port. And as you can see, that's like a port range. And then what were the other ones here? The Archon port. So let's just copy this in. Oh. So 8080-8081, and then the web map port, 8082, may as well just do this. Okay, so then we're going to open up that range, then all we need to do is click submit, and then we'll see, oh actually, we can't use 8080 because this panel is going to use 8080, but let's just delete that one, otherwise that will cause issues. That's okay, you could assign it to another port, it's not a big deal. But yeah, as we can see, we've got the other ports here. They're all in, so we just, exactly the same as what I did before, we just need to go back and assign the ports that we need to the server now. So let's go, what was it? Just add all of these different ports, and then remove the 27017, and then update the build configuration. Cool, so now we got the default port is 26900. Now there's one other thing we need to check. I don't know if this game has it, but if you go to startup, sometimes there is like a default port here that we would need to change. So as you can see here, it's got the telnet port, but it looks like, yeah, there's no port here, so we can literally just go back to Pterodactyl. Well, it's just the dashboard, And then, yeah, if we click on our server, now we can see that the port is now 26900. So it's actually super simple. It's just adding the allocations now. One thing to be aware of is that this is not opening ports. This is just assigning ports. Opening ports is more to do with the firewall on your server. So if you're using like the Ubuntu firewall, for example, you'll need to check in UFW that all your rules have these ports open and then not blocking these ports for whatever reason. So this is simply just allocating it inside the Pterodactyl software. So, all right, so that's it, guys. It's just a super quick video today. If you get stuck, come join us on Discord. We got plenty of people who are willing to help out. And yeah, thanks for watching. Subscribe, like, you know, all that jazz. And I hope to see you in the next video.